Hello, it's me. So all of us are a little bit probably anxious and uncertain about what the future may hold. Certainly a lot of us have businesses and we're unsure of what's going to be our future. There's a lot of you that work in a hospital and I think you're doing a marvellous job and I love you for what you're doing. And I just wanted to say that there are things that I can do to help you. So I'm thinking at the moment that we all possibly might be struggling with sleep, thinking of horrible, stupid thoughts that might not even occur. Nighttime's worst time for that. And so what I'm going to give you is reflexology points that can really help. Reflexology points that can help you, especially if you're sort of in your lounge and with dim lighting, the heating's on, you might have your legs covered up with a blanket. This will make you feel quite sleepy, and actually probably best to do it in bed, because that's when you're actually your mind sometimes can wake up. I tend to think at these times it's best not to overanalyze the news, and best not to watch the news just before you go into sleep, because that is not, it's just not wise. It's scaremongering. A lot of it is scaremongering. We're healthy, we're well, and so long as we're well, we would only get sort of mild to more severe flu symptoms, and you know, we'll get out the other side. Even our older parents or relatives will get through it to the other side. We just need to be sensible and cautious. So, seeing as I can't see anyone at home, because obviously it's very close proximity and it's working with skin to skin, I'm going to do the odd video on here. And so this can help with what reflexology points I'm going to work on today. It's basically the head, and that includes obviously the eyes and the ears, but all the fingers have points on them that really can help you. And reflexology as a whole is a very grounding, even though you feel some tension points, it's very relaxing, and a lot of my clients say it helps them to get restorative sleep, which is brilliant, and that's what we all need to boost our immune systems. So I think that's crucial. So without further ado, I'm going to show you a couple of techniques that you will be using, but don't worry if you can't get used to them, just do sort of circular actions, that's fine, don't worry about it, because honestly we're doing the same thing, it's just you don't need to do the proper techniques, it's fine, you'll still be helping yourself, especially if you're sort of in a calm, relaxed environment. You can do this on your partner, you can do this on your children. I'll be showing you in the other videos how to massage your children. I'll be showing you how to help your shoulders and your neck, things with your migraine. And actually some of these points today can help you with tension, headaches and migraines, etc. So, firstly, I'm just going to show you some techniques. So I'm going to show it this way, I would normally show it that way. So we just literally bring the skin forward and we peel it back. So you're doing a rocking motion, but to the side of your, okay? And you're doing that, we'll do the top couple of bits of our thumb. And I'll explain what points there are in a minute. But a lot of what we do is finger walking or finger crawling. And that's doing this, literally, you're doing a rocking movement, okay? It's very, very simple. You can practice on your arm before you do it on your hands, and if you can reach your foot, you can bring your foot up. You can do this on the foot. It's really good. Okay, so to start off with, I'm going to simply, I'm going on the base of, basically like the ball point of my hand, and I'm going to the centre, and I'm going to put my thumb in there, and it's a bit weird telling yourself this, but it's what we do. So we're going to take three deep breaths and push into that point, and then let your breath out. You see I'm gently releasing, push in, and out, and one last time in, and out. Okay, and this is your diaphragm, okay, in the terms of reflexology. And that's just your solar plexus, and we do that anyway. And normally we do sort of be pushing and pulling and turning your hand around, back again. And I'll be doing sort of a bit of a hand massage on you before I even start the reflexology. But for the sake of this video, I'm just simply going to show you some points. But you can do this on yourself, because you can see it's really easy, and it's very, it's lovely, and it's good, it's soothing. So we're going to start off with finger walking the whole of the hand. Like I said, this is just a simple rocking motion, going up your hand, simple rocking motion. You can practice on your arm before you go on to doing your hand, but don't worry if you're having to do it in circular motions, going up, because that's fine as well. I'm going to start with the thumb. I'm going to try and show you, I'll do it this way. So I'm pushing and pulling, pushing and pulling. This is a pituitary gland. You might feel this is quite tender. You can do some circular movements here. Good. It's not always comfortable, but it's good. And this is your hypothalamus gland, and this is good as well. And yet again, I'm doing the same technique. Okay, and I would probably do some circular movements in there as well. Okay, and those two glands are really good for balancing. So when you're feeling a bit out of kilter, when you're feeling a bit overwhelmed, when maybe you've got a headache or a migraine, do them. And they're really good. You do either side of your thumb, because one side on the right is all the nerves in the front of your face. It's got a big word, but with a T, and I'm just not going to pronounce it for you. And on the other side is nose, but actually the nose is all covered along the fingers as well. So this is you've got your eyes and ears. So this is a bit of a alien part, because everything else after that is all mapped out. Normal, you've got your gallbladder on one side, your spleen on the other side. Your heart's more on the left than it is on the right. And actually, people sometimes ask me, does it cross over? So when you're doing the right hand, is that really on the left hand side? No. It's left side of the body, right side of the body. Okay, so we're doing, so we've done this, and I would move down and go down to your adrenals, okay? And this is well known for helping with stress and sort of headaches, etc. It helps with a lot of things, okay? And now I'm not going to do the whole routine for you. But you can cover your own, your whole hand, and if you do want some advice on how to go, to how to do something specific, you can give me a message, and I'll help you. But I am asking for donation by Bax or PayPal invoice, because I'm trying to keep my business afloat. So as you can see, I have done finger walking. And I'm doing circling up my finger. And some of you will find that there are some sore spots there. And I would concentrate on them, okay? I think that's really important. I'm focusing on the top of my finger as well. I'm gonna do it, press down on the top, because that's the brain, because on each of these fingers, there is the brain on the top, okay? Like I say, do this on your children, on your family, when you're all a bit uptight or a little bit crazy. Really good. So is massaging children. There is, you know, honestly, just put on some relaxing music and you'll probably find you all feel a lot better within yourselves. So that's quite important, especially because we don't know how long this is going to go on for. So do get out, go in your garden, go to the moors, go to the beach, because there'll be hardly anyone there and you can easily keep away from people. And make sure you get out, because otherwise your sleep will be affected. And sleep is the big thing that helps support your immune system. It's not just healthy eating. It really is getting out, doing some exercise. The children won't sleep very well if you don't get them out. You know that. All parents, so it's important that we do. And even being in a village, doesn't matter, we still get out, go to a garden, go to the park. I expect you can keep more than, you know, 2 meters away or whatever it is. Really, really important. No, you can really do these things on this side, because actually it's different on this side. So you've got teeth and mouth. Okay, and it's you'll find, you know, if I was doing it on you, I'd be finding specific spots, which you can probably find yourself. I'd be going and covering the whole of the body, obviously, and able to tell you what I'm feeling. And all that you'll be feeling is very normal, so you don't need to worry about that. Okay. It's an old cough. So I'm going to also say about tell you about what you can do on your face, because on your face there are things that you can do, like lying in bed. Oh, I'm feeling quite, I'm just thinking of things too much. What am I going to do to help myself? What am I going to do with the children? I've got all this home learning and they've been rubbish. Actually, you could do the reflexology before, calm them down, get them regulated, then go on into it. But for me, I'm still going to keep my routine. So the children are still going to get dressed in their normal time. They're going to start their learning at 9, and I'm going to have, I'm saying this now, and at 11:15 they're going to have half an hour break, and then they'll be done by lunchtime. And after lunchtime they've got their whole afternoon, whole evening off, and I'm going to get them out. I'm going to take a thermos, I'm going to take a bit of a snack and get out, because God help us if we were in the house all that time. It's not healthy at all for anybody, and I think that's applicable to all families. Okay. So now, on the face, you're lying down in bed, you're thinking of a whole load of crap stuff. Okay, so I struggle with the Reiki, but actually there is a self Reiki guide, and actually, God, when I did it, I could feel things happening. I was lying down in bed, and like, oh my goodness, I can feel it, I'm just doing it, and I'm feeling like all this, I felt like stuff coming up to my head. It's a really odd feeling to describe, but I was lying down even last night and I was struggling to get off to sleep, and I did this, and I could feel it sort of coming up to me. But this, so you just simply hold it, your head, lying down for like a couple of seconds doing that, honestly, you feel you'll understand. Close your eyes, you'll understand what I mean. Into your hair. That's quite sensuous. And it's quite comforting because, you know, obviously it's little girls, even boys, men, like that. Okay, and then I'm going to go to the upper side of the eyes. So you can see here, I've got a nice spot there, oh dear. And here. So I'm just simply going to do circular movements around my eyes. Okay. You can feel, when you're tired, you're stressed, your eyes strain, you get, you know, those of you that get those tension headaches, that will help. There's another technique I'll show you in a minute. And if you're just lying in bed and you're trying to get to sleep, I'll just do some circular movements around my eyes. I might just do this. All those things can make you feel quite sleepy. So there's aspects, I'm not going to show you all how to do a face massage, but that's a sort of a little bit of an aspect. And there's lots of other things that I do, but that can really help you. Simply just doing this, your head, you're covering a lot of different acupressure points. You're helping reduce tension within your head. So there's a lot of different things you can do. One of the most effective things, if you've got a tension headache, I don't think I've got any bit of paper up here. My daughter keeps on nicking them, Jessica. Okay. So I would use, especially if you're in the hospital and you're working at a desk, you're at a desk all the time, and you're up to your eyeballs, or even that you're working in a ward and you're going to have a coffee. This doesn't take hardly any of your time, but it can really, really make a difference. Because I know I've got family, and one member of my family has had migraines because they are at the forefront of this. This is really easy to do. So you see where my pupils are. I'm just going to line up my fingers, okay? I'm going to then look at my fingers. I'm going to start to move them gradually away. And I'm just seeing, relaxing my eyes, to four fingers, okay? And if you're struggling, just bring them closer until you get four, you'll see four fingers instead of two. That helps all the muscles around your eyes to relax. And those of us that have sons or daughters that have lazy eyes, well, if they were adults, they would be able to do that exercise and relax their eyes. And I can't think of that eye name, the doctor for the person, but that's basically what he told me, that my eyes were being a bit lazy and that I actually needed to relax them, or the muscles around them. I've done it when I've had tension headache, that releases it. Okay, so there's a few pointers I'm hoping that you can take away. Like I say, you can use lavender oil, just in your sunflower oil, virgin olive oil, almond, grape seed, more or less any oil that you have. There's still lots, so long as you're not allergic. Use it on your children, because I tell you, you'll make them feel a lot more calmer and balanced, because actually it's a huge change, not for just us, but for them as well. So if anyone needs me, just give me a message. I can help you with specific points. But like I say, I'm just asking for a donation through BACS or through PayPal invoice, because I'm just trying to keep myself afloat, as we all are. Anyway, I love you and leave you, and I'll see you girls later. Bye.